Evening folks, this is Best and Slot and welcome back to Black Rock Park, our modern North American zoo. And in today's video, we are finally going to add our very first animal. It's taken a little bit of time. We had to do our little intro bit and then we had to do the big old staff building. The staff building is of course not quite finished. I have done a little bit more work. I've been racking my brain about this over and over again. And I decided to replace the flooring with concrete. Now, I've only done the bottom floor, but I think already having a floor that's different than the roof and different than the sides and kind of fits that slight industrial stark feeling we've got going on is a big improvement. I still need to cover the thing in decorations and stuff like that, but I've added some lights onto the roof. Lots and lots of work to do in here, but it is a start. So I'm going to replace the other floors with concrete, and we'll just kind of work on this over time. But today is Bison Day, so the idea for the bison, I've had a pretty cool idea based literally on one of your comments. Now, one of you suggested that this bison here could be like a myth or a fable that's kind of become attached to Black Rock Park because of the ghosty appearance. This is the ghost of Black Rock Park. You know, this ancient bison who roams the fields after dying here, defending his family from, I don't know, invaders or whatever, just something like that. We'll invent a story as we go along. And we're going to make a whole thing about the ghost of Black Rock Park. Like, that, we're going to build a story around it and kind of attach it a little bit to the exhibit. I don't really know how we're going to do that quite yet. I've got to think about that a bit, but I liked that idea. It gives that story and a little bit of twist that I really like having in my parks. So well done, whoever it was who suggested that. Of course, I forgot to get your name. So yeah, we're going to work on the bison exhibit. It's going to be about this big. It's not going to be huge, but it's going to go to around here, and it's going to go under the river, and it's going to come out onto this side on the right as well. So it's going to be one bison exhibit viewed from both sides of the same bridge, and we're going to build two little viewing areas as well. We're going to have to find a better place for this transformer. Don't know where that's going to go. Well, I'll have to hide that somewhere. Might just swap that with a solar panel and leave it there. And then have probably identical viewing areas on both sides to keep that symmetry going. And then a little Black Rock ghost display and then the bison exhibit. Very exciting stuff. I've only got $19,000. I'm hoping it's enough to carry me through here. And then we can actually open the park and hopefully get some money rolling in for the very first time. But we'll have to see. And yeah, thank you for all the comments and suggestions and stuff like that. Finally, we get to the animals. Let's get started. Here we go then, time-lapse time. For reference, this is about nearly 3 hours worth of work, it must be said. 3 hours worth of work and cut down to about 20 minutes. I think we're on about 7 to 8 times speed. I will say most of the work is not spent on the actual enclosure. Most of it is spent on the park itself, the area around the enclosure. The enclosures themselves end up relatively simple. One of the problems I have with the bison in general is they favour grassland. Now, I do end up using trees and plants from outside of the grassland. They're still very, very happy bison, don't get me wrong, but it's a bison. It lives on a plains. It's not the most interesting sort of area to build, so what I wanted to do instead was make the area around it, the way of viewing the exhibit, to be much more interesting. Now, unfortunately, we're still not in profit as I make this video right now. Despite having all the bison in at this point, like 6 or 7 of them, we're still not making money because the viewing is a little bit haphazard. I'm not sure I love the idea in general, this underground tunnel on both sides, the bison, because I've only got one really good viewing area, so it kind of acted against me a little bit. I'm considering scrapping one half of the exhibit, actually this side on the right hand side, and turning it into something else entirely down the line, but we'll have to wait and see. The more I think about it, the more I think I'm definitely going to do that, but we'll see what happens. Excuse me. But the exhibit itself ends up okay. I really did want it to, even though it's a plains, I just wanted it to be a little bit interesting, so we're going to have a little raised area here at the back. We've got the tunnel going underground, we're going to add a river, we're going to have loads of rocks, we're going to have a little bit of a story to tell. Now, I'm going to tell you all about the story later on, but you will see us when we're building the viewing area for that story in a little bit. So, just making a little cave at this point in time. Really is just about having viewing areas on both sides. I decided to not have a viewing area for that right this side here on the left here, and just have like a really nice one on the other side. But we'll talk about that later. It's fine. Anyways, bison. Finally, we're going to have an animal in our park. I can hit the play button every now and again. It's very exciting stuff. It really is. This one little bison is just gonna. Oh, yep. I just wanted some ideas, some inspiration. I didn't really get anything other than, hey, maybe I should have a river. That was about as far as it got, and it didn't really start off that well. I think I did end up keeping some water in there somehow. I'm trying to remember how I did it. Kind of wanted to mix this up. Initially, the idea was for this to be very straight and organized, you know, these little bits to the side of the bridge. And I think that looked okay, and it kind of suited the modern kind of approach, but as soon as you bring an exhibit into there, and the bison can go in the water, at least on one of the sides, I think as soon as you've got animals in there, then having that very straight-lined edge kind of ruins the effect a little bit. So I killed that with, like, pure prejudice, just... Sorry. So just doing our terrain work at the moment, a little bit of sort of dirt and rock around the tunnels, a little dirt around the outskirts of the rivers, and a little bit of stone on top of the taller mountain bit as well. Got a little confused for a minute because our bison has tons of animals, tons of plants in its enclosure that aren't suited, and it's because of the bridge. The enclosure goes, of course, across the bridge as well. Even if the bison, for fairly obvious reasons, can't go on the bridge, that would be crazy. But the bridge does have like a little grassy, planty area inside it, and that little grassy, planty area counts as in the enclosure, and therefore the bison is complaining a little bit. But they do end up very happy, like 94% happiness, so that's fine. Like, all these little trees here, these aren't technically meant to be in there, but I figure adding plants from the temperate location, temperate North America, although it's not grassland like it should be, I figure temperate North America is pretty good anyway. I figure that's okay, you know, I think I can get away with that, personally. And all these images I see of the bison, there's always these fairly big forests behind them and stuff like that. Now, whether that's because the game is just overly strict on bison habitats, or there's just not enough trees in the grassland environment, because grasslands do have trees, sometimes. I don't know, but... Heyo. So adding some reeds in there, decided I'm going to love reeds because I don't like reeds. I'm trying to teach myself to love the reed. I'll get there eventually. But they add these bulrushes in particular have a really cool effect to them. And really just a lot of nettles, because nettles are one of the few plants we can play with on the grassland. Nettles and the goldenrod, which is my nickname in college. And one thing I'm trying to do a lot more, because I used to just kind of put plants down haphazardly. If you stack them next to each other, like big, small, little, and kind of mess around like that a little bit, it does give it a much more natural kind of feeling. It's something I never used to do. It's something I want to do a lot more. I will say, I'm not totally thrilled with the enclosures. They're a bit boring. But the viewing area that we're going to get to around them, like probably way before halfway through this video, I really like. I've super enjoyed this video. It took me back. It reminded me quite a lot of when we were building the African section in our franchise zoo, in the, you know, the beta franchise zoo. Little cave here, little hidden cave, little pocket of flowers, you know. We're gonna talk about that story as well. It really reminded me of that. Like, it was a very similar way of building. It's something I've not been able to do in a long time. Build an actual zoo, build an actual park with, like, guest things. So I actually really enjoyed it, and I think it turned out really well, but we'll get to that bit in a little bit. Just sticking our foliage down, really, just doing little pockets and a little sort of slightly more dead area, and now begins the stones. They actually couldn't escape here, it was interesting. There's a null barrier there, so you'd think in theory the bison could go up that ledge and walk around, but for some reason the game prevents them from doing that. Still, even though the game doesn't let them do that, I figured we should put in an actual in-universe reason for why they can't, and it simply is blocked off with the rocks. That makes a little bit more sense. Or does it? Maybe they're magical. Maybe it's a magic bison. You don't know. I'm not here to judge. So, just looking some rocks in. Rocks are the best. And a log. I love that log. That log actually made, like, if you had to pick, like, a single individual favorite item in the entire game, that log may be my favorite. It's close between that and, I don't know, some other stuff, probably. But I do love that log. It's my favorite log. I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite log on the Citadel. But rocks are going to help us just make the environment look a little bit more interesting. It's very uppy-downy, it's the official term, which is what I wanted. I didn't want to just do a flat plains, you know, I just can't bring myself to do it. And although it's not the most interesting formation, it lacks elevation to an extent, compared to, say, some of the exhibits I want to build down the line. It is meant to be a plain, so it does need these flatter areas. Even though the tunnel kind of ruins that a little bit, it's still fairly flat with just some slight changes in elevation and then a big ass tunnel, basically. I think it worked out pretty well. And this is, we're doing the same thing I said before, just making that little bit of water a little bit more interesting. So it's still a bridge going over there, but it's got like a little bit more of a natural vibe. I've realized that I'm being too close to the modern. Like, I really want to push the modern. The lighting is going to be modern, the buildings are going to be modern, all that is going to be modern, but And we'll see this in a little bit as well. You need that kind of. What I'm doing here, by the way, is buying pandas to sell to make money because I ran out of cash, basically. Excuse me, my throat is. There's a small demon in there, like gargling or something. I don't know what's going on, but it's crazy. Yeah, just adding our enrichment items. I'd already done the bison research. Again, we're gonna bring in more bison later on. You're gonna be part of that. That's gonna be at the end of the video, well, after the time lapse. I'm gonna stop building like this, by the way, so close to the edge of the map because it means I can't put trees behind the fence, and it really upsets me. Like, I really want to put trees behind there, and I can't. But the exhibits themselves are pretty much done at this point. Now, what we're gonna do is work on the actual how we're gonna view them. I really want to do something symmetrical, but then I started having all these ideas, and we're gonna talk about it. But one of the ideas you guys at home gave me was the idea of the ghost of Blackrock, and I started to form this whole story about the ghost of Blackrock, this ancient bison. Again, we'll talk about that a little later on, but you're gonna see the idea is like a little, as you're walking up to the bison enclosure, you would get like a little educational bit about this like local legend of the ghost of Blackrock, this bison, this ancient bison. So you're gonna see him, he's gonna have like a little statue here, and then we're gonna have like an informational board telling you the story of the ghost. I have to write the story still and put it on the signs, but that is the idea. And I think this whole area ends up looking really, really cool. I'm super proud of this a little bit. It took a little finagling, but I think it worked out really, really well at the end. These fences are odd. I just want to say this. These fences are really odd. Like the ones that I'm stacking on top of the metal right here. Because you turn on. I don't know what's going on here, by the way. You turn on position snap. And half the time they snap in the right position. And then at the other angle, they refuse to turn. The position snap is. The angle snap is always wrong 50% of the time, basically. It's very strange. I didn't really have any idea for this. I just thought I'd start chucking stuff in. And we get there eventually. It ends up looking pretty cool, I think. I believe I scrapped most of that. Now we need to do the ghost. Now we need big fonts, don't we? I hate this bit, by the way. Like, not my build. The fonts down there that, you know, that I'm selecting right here. They're all in the wrong place. I don't know why. It's like, none of it makes sense. It doesn't go small letters and then big letters. It goes like small letters, and then they'll chuck a few extra things in there, like the ampersand randomly. And then it goes big letters like halfway through the alphabet, and then it goes back to small letters again. It's utter nonsense. I have no idea why it said R like that at all. Just had to rearrange a little bit here, basically add the letters in afterwards so they curved a little bit on that curvy wood. There it is, the ghost of Blackrock. There's our ghost. We're gonna scrap that. We're gonna make it look a little bit more natural, so we're gonna layer this with rock. We're gonna give him like a big thing to stand on, basically like that. There he is, there's our ghost of Blackrock. Lower it down a little bit, and we're also going to change the colour of that font in a little bit as well. This is what I want to do. It has to feel modern and lit up, you know, very much modern utilities and modern lights and stuff like that, but with nods to the natural history of the place. The idea is Blackrock is this ancient, it used to be, like, fairly important to the Native Americans in the area, and I kind of want to emphasise that kind of feeling, you know, this is a place of myth and legend, and yes, we're, you know, selling it essentially and bringing all these modern utilities in, but that doesn't mean we can't pay homage to what was there in the past. And there's the mist, because he's a ghost. It reminds me of, just use a football analogy for a moment, Anfield, right? Liverpool Football Club, we play Anfield, and Anfield is ancient. It's decades and decades and decades and decades old, you know, one of the most renowned, famous stadiums on the planet. And some clubs, when they want to expand their stadium, what it's easiest to do generally is either knock down your stadium and build a new one there, or indeed build another stadium somewhere else and just get rid of your current one. What we're doing at Anfield, to more expense to an extent, is kind of redesigning Anfield from the ground up, or like we'll edit the current stand so it retains the original shape. The housing is the same, but it houses more people and it's more modern and stuff like that, right? That's kind of the feeling I want to get across with Blackrock. It's modern, it holds a lot of guests, you know, it makes money, blah, 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 but it also pays homage and is respectful towards what came before us. And in this case, it was this Native American community. There's the word. So that's the idea going forward. So we're going to bring in a little bit more decoration that's a little bit less strictly modern, but I really do want the bones of the place to feel modern and unique in that kind of way, in that bright lights and hard edges and angles and stuff like that. But then bringing in the rock and the mist and these legends, and we're going to use some like wooden sign things from the African region in a little bit as well. That's my theme going forward, because it gives me a little bit more creative control, and it's going to look cool. So here we're doing, this is going to be the display area for the story, for the legend of the Ghost of Blackrock. So I'm just going to do what I've been doing quite a lot. I'm doing like a little water display, because again, that's a running theme. You know, you'd have things that would resonate throughout your entire zoo. This would be one of them. So I'm going to chuck a little bit of water in there. Water. It's a northern way of saying water. A little bit of water in there, lovely stuff, and move the glass back is the idea. So it's kind of like a half and half kind of thing, like so. Beautiful. Do need to add lights to this whole thing, I've not done that quite yet. I really wanted to get some water at the bottom of there, and it was proving difficult, but we do manage it. I think with the, not that one, is it that one? No, it's not that one. I think it's this one. If you sink this one down low enough, and then get it in the right place, the water doesn't leak out, but it looks like it's kind of running there underneath the rocks. It's really cool, actually. It worked out pretty well, I would say. And yeah, I'm gonna get rid of that because that's stupid. And yeah, pretty happy with this. A little bit of plant life in there, mainly the reeds, I think. I don't think I put anything else in there. Don't want to go overboard. And then this middle bit is where we're gonna tell the story. So let's tell that story. So far, and I do want help on this story, like if any of you have any ideas, I've given you the bare bones, this is the idea, you know. Well, I will give you those bare bones. Look, I can brief today, it's nice. I can give you those bare bones a little bit later on in the video, during the non-time-lapse bit. We'll talk about the story of this ancient bison. But, big but. I like them, cannot lie. I wouldn't mind some extra details, so if you have any suggestions for the tale of this ancient bison of Black Rock, feel free to let me know. Listen to what I'm going to say later on about it, you know, there's some screaming women in my apartment. Again, not in a good way. Yeah, just let me know what you think, and we'll work on something cool. This is kind of what I mean. These are African things, but they have that modern kind of edge, yet still a little bit organic as well. I think that organic modern is like a really cool angle to take with this park. You know, like metal and organic meeting. Kind of like in horror films when they splice like an animal with like a robot, or like a human with a robot, and it's all disastrous. And just little things like this. This little pattern I'm going to make with the diamond shapes here. Just, yeah, just little things like that. Organic modern, that's what we're going for. That's a good idea, I like that. This little thing, just some chains at the back. The bison has been released. Yeah, so I do think this little area here is a perfect example of the themes I'm kind of trying to go for here. You know, we've got the plant life growing up, but it's still very modern in approach. It's this nice combo of the two. The Tale of the Ghost. And so that's going to be the title bit up there, and then you're going to have like 12 boards worth that we can tell the story underneath. I was doing a little test to see how much text you can actually fit on. It's not that much, so the story's going to have to be fairly well controlled. But that's it. Now, with that bit done, we need to build the viewing area itself. This is going to be a little bit more simple, although, again, with some pretty cool little touches, I think. That was a disaster of a staircase. It was pretty hard to get the staircase working, but we got there eventually. So yeah, this is mainly going to be about fitting the wood around it, first of all, in a way that makes sense, but we get there eventually, I think. And just making a cool little viewing area, basically. Because the exhibit itself is not that exciting, and I don't think it's ever going to be, I really did want everything else to feel just a little bit more special, and feel a bit more like a zoo, feel nicely contained. This zoo is going to be much, much smaller than the last one. I know right now it's actually fairly huge. I do intend to contain that just a little bit more going forward, because huge zoos don't make money, and I want to make money. I'm so tired of having to like buy things for CC and then spend a fortune. Turn this little viewing area just into a little resting area as well, because it just kind of fit, I guess. Did want to do a little viewing area in there, but it's not going to work. And again, we're just kind of covering this whole shebang in a little bit of wood, just to yeah, make it look a little bit more professional, I guess. There's going to be a lot of woodwork here, ladies. a lot of woodwork going on here. A little bison mural thing going on there. We'll put some trees in front of it as well, so it's less obnoxious. There's a lot of woodwork here where we have to kind of like put items into groups and then get rid of the groups, and it's all a little bit messy, but I guess so. Hiding the water filter around that back. We're not really going to go there for a little while. Actually, we're going to go there in the next episode. I don't know what I'm on about. But yeah, I'll find a better way to put that water thing in later on. Yeah, just decorating the area. Trees! I love my trees. I can't be helped. I love trees. How are we doing? Got a few minutes left, about 4 minutes left. Can't remember what I do. A lot of it's... Okay, yeah, it's all finishing this off. We're going to make a little... I can't remember where I got the idea from. I saw somebody do it, but they made like a little wooden housing for the... This is what I mean, by the way, just to backtrack quickly. Those little signs there, they're like... I think they're from the African zone, but they could, you know, function as Native American, for example, for sure. It's kind of, you know, a slightly rougher, more man-made looking wooden pole thing. I think it suits really well, that mixing that with the modern materials. I really like how that looks. So that's the kind of thing we're going for going forward. I think the whole area still looks modern, but it kind of suggests something more traditional as well. Now, I really liked this idea as well, but it doesn't work with these flowers. So I'm going to get rid of all of that, as you'll see. And we're going to try lots of different things and eventually go for these big-ass bushes. The whole thing ends up getting absolutely covered. There they are. And that goes, that kind of wraps around towards there, like so. Again, just, yeah, I don't know, looks nice. Puts a few flowers in there as well, make it look like a more natural trellis kind of thing, I guess. Overgrown, but in a controlled way. That's the theme. And I really like those bushes, so I ended up putting them everywhere. And then that kind of drops down around the glass. A couple of donation boxes, and then it's time for our screen. I think. Screen time, yeah. Oh, I've gone. There we go, screen time. So I really, instead of just sticking it there, which is what I always do, I thought, again, we'd put a little bit of work in. I know. So I really wasn't sure what to do over here. I had this viewing area, and I was just going to have a path walk up to it. I do think it's better to have the viewing area on one side, and I've put all the food on that side as well. So the buffalo were kind of, the bison I should say, are basically they're being lured over to, from this side, the right-hand side. As you walk in, they're being lured over to the left. And they're kind of directed to go over there because that's where all the food is. And the other side could be more like a treatment area or like a breeding area or something like that. I think having two areas is... It's splitting my park up too much. I don't want people walking over here necessarily because this is not where everything else is going to be. And I couldn't get the path to where everything was annoying me basically over in this section. So although it's there right now, what we will end up doing is scrapping that whole area and just filling it in with trees, essentially. So what I really want to do was to have a display case for our viewing board rather than just having standing there on the wall on its own or just having it, you know, on the signpost things. Make like a little wooden display case to house it properly. So that's what I'm doing. I really like these wooden boards. These look really cool. And we're just going to cover that in wood and give it some supports that attach down onto the exhibit. Eventually. There we go. And you sneeze really badly. It's cute though, isn't it? I think it's really cute. Sorry about that. Oh boy. We are nearly done. I think at this point it was just, yeah, deciding that I'm not gonna do that. We're just gonna scrap that. We're gonna cover it in big old trees, a little bit of forest, and that's basically how we're gonna finish things off. Like I said, the park is not yet making money. It is still a fairly huge park for only one animal, basically. So what we're going to do in the next video, again, we'll talk about this, I'm sure, is after the bison, we're going to do our next habitat straight after the bison. And again, try to make that close and try to make a viewing area that brings those animals really close. Get people down into that part of the park and hopefully bringing in a little bit of cash. I also want to do a science center. I've talked about this before, but I'll talk about it again briefly. That's going to be right in front of where we are now. That's going to house our exhibit animals. That's going to have like science experiments. And we're just going to have a lot of fun designing some really cool stuff for that kind of area. But I think that is... Oh, punching my desk. That is about it. Yep, we're done in 10 seconds. So thank you for joining me for the time lapse. We will go add many more bison. And we will discuss what we're doing next. So hope you've enjoyed. Are we done? I think we're done. There we go. Right then, folks, time lapse officially over. We can add a few more bison and make sure they're all happy and ready to go. I'm going to try to not explain what I've just done in this part of the video because inevitably I've already done it. But we can have a sort of slow motion tour. There's the little foresty bit that we did at the end. But really, I want to focus on this bit over here with the ghost of Blackrock. You can't quite always see the Blackrock, but there's the ghost right there in his misty little background. And over here, we're going to write the story of the ghost. Of course, this is something I kind of want you guys to get involved with. I'm sure I've already said that, so I don't know why I'm saying it. But it'd be cool if you guys can get involved. What is the tale of the ghost? In my mind, I can explain this. He's like It's this ancient bison that was roaming the plains of Blackrock. You know, this was a natural place once, Blackrock, like this ancient site, North America, you know, Native America, and all this kind of jazz. And that's why we're kind of starting to bring in some slightly le I need to put lights in, I just remembered. Some, you know, slightly less modern elements, kind of fusing the modern with the classic in order to hopefully create a like a modern zoo that still has a nod to what would have been Native American heritage in the area. Even the cave over here, I was actually meant to do this, so I haven't done it yet. I kind of wanted this cave to have some like cave markings and stuff on the walls, just to, you know, emphasize the idea that people used to live in there, basically. Or even in this underground bit as well. I also need lights, I gotta remember the lights. And there's this ancient bison roaming, you know, respected. It's like an elder amongst the community, respected even by the locals. You know, he wasn't hunted because they saw the value in sometimes allowing nature to do its thing in order to, you know, allow for proliferation of the species and therefore more to hunt in the future, right? That's the problem we have with overfishing and stuff right now. If you don't allow the fish to breed at all because you're killing them all, then eventually you're going to run out of fish to breed in the first place. You have to allow nature to have its way if you want to, you know, use those natural resources. So that was kind of the idea. They realized the importance of the elders to this bison community and left them alone. But then, when you know, basically the English came and everyone else decided to come and invade America, and sort of take over the natural land and all this terrible things that we all did. You know, the bison was like the last one standing at Black Rock. The herd were getting slaughtered, Native Americans were getting pushed back, and the bison kind of like stood his ground and defended Black Rock, his native home, for as long as he could. He's like a valiant defender who eventually went down, but now he roams the land. He's a nice ghost, he's a pleasant ghost, but only to those who are respectful of the natural environment, which may not look like it, you know, considering we've built this massive modern zoo on top, but that's why we're gonna have areas that are kind of like more open towards the natural environment and the history of the area and all this kind of stuff. So the tale of the ghost right there, and we'll have more stuff like this. I kind of like this a lot because it does, I think, still look quite modern because of the floor and the walls and stuff like that. But then there's little hints of, you know, just some slightly different stuff popping in there, here and there. And I think that's something we need to do, otherwise the whole zoo's going to end up a little bit on the boring side. So I'm going to try to keep adding those influences in now and again. I will say I love this. I think this area is really cool. Right then, one thing we need to do before we go is add many more bison. I had a little look, and I cannot remember. Freed 15, up to 14 males, up to 14 females. So I think there's only going to be one bull, but I think we can get, say, 3 or 4 males and, say, 10 females or something like that, which would be pretty cool. And it's quite a large exhibit that you can only really properly view from here and from the bridge. So I think it's important to have lots of animals, basically. Now, whether that's a good idea in terms of my funding is a whole other kettle of fish. But we shall see. Let's get all our bison in, shall we? You're already getting delivered. All right. So we should have 2 females and a male so far, I believe. Oh, one of the females is a it's a gold baby that I got from completing like one of the old challenges. I really need to do the other challenge. So we've got 2 females-ish. Doesn't really count, but let's get a few more bison, shall we? Let's get rid of my giant pandas. I've still not done the panda challenge. I'm so slacking on the panda challenge. It's gonna come back and bite me in the boot. There it is. It's not my favorite of the exhibit designs. I didn't really want to screw around too much with the foliage or indeed the elevation or the shape or anything like that. This is our starter exhibit at the end of the day. But still, it's pretty cool. Let's have a little tour of what we've done so far. I really need to make this a staff area. People don't want to. I don't want people walking down here. Oh no, what's up? Do I have another feeder? Yeah, I've got this. There's a thing, right? Because my animals aren't currently hungry, right? They're not starving to death right now. The keeper will not feed the feeder, which is so incredibly stupid that I can't possibly begin to wrap my head around it. My animals are going to be hungry at some point soon, right? I have to wait till my animals are basically half starving before my keeper will actually feed them. It makes no sense at all. It is nonsense. Absolute bloody nonsense. But it's what it is. Yeah, I don't think I'm making money yet. People are sort of coming over here.
But I'm not walking up to the top. I'm going to put another donation box down there. I want people up here. Grumble, grumble. Right, okay, I need to think about this. I mean, the bison are staying around on this right-hand side, which is cool. And they look great. I'll give them that much. They really do. They're very cool. Give me money. I think we need some shops. And then maybe a slightly more accessible exhibit. But I mean, surely you can see it from in here as well now. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Hey, look at that. That's very cool. I really like that. Yeah. They're chuffed. And this is a good way to see these animals over here. You can spot them. You're not meant to get an amazing look, but you can see them. People are just standing in the stupidest places. I am still losing money. I'm wondering if a shop's thing will increase sex ratio. Though that's not literally, that's not, it's literally not possible. You're wrong, game. You're wrong. What? It doesn't. What? Should I just get rid of the other males? Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of the other males. That upsets me. I have to keep an eye out for more females then. We're just going to have one male and tons of females. I'm not spending 10,000 on a bronze bison, however. Nice though, isn't it? Yay. It's poo everywhere. Can I have a keeper, please? Right. But there's only one keeper! Oh, they're going to feed. They're going to feed. Go back over there. Oh, okay, I see the problem with this one. Okay, well, at least this is big ass exhibit. I can't believe I'm still losing money. People are viewing over there. Nobody's really, people are coming here, but they're not coming up far enough. On the plus side, though, it looks really nice, right? That is literally the most important thing. I need to have a little think, though. Right, finally got there. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey, folks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.